I haven't even done anything.
Right?
Hello, friends. Welcome back to another evening of Dungeons and Dragons.
Can't wait for Paul to find out Felix's true name. Mr. Nesgrim. We're all Nesgrim down here.
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
Hi. This one's fucking broken.
We're not great RPG, and Don's mic is dead.
Nah, I got it. I
unmuted
him. Yeah,
himself on the tablet.
He has all of the power.
Mm-hmm. We're good. It's fine. Yeah, we're here for the city of Oshuamp again, and we have a new cast member joining us, which mm-hmm. is very exciting.
Mm-hmm. Or is it?
Mm-hmm.
True. It's true. It's true. It could be horrifying.
Welcome.
We're so excited.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'm glad to be here.
That's it.
Gally, thank you very much for the gifted sub. Aww. Whenever Gally's here and anyone speaks that doesn't have a sub, Gally immediately gifts them. So I appreciate that, mm-hmm. Gally. It's very nice of you and it's very good for me. So mm-hmm. thanks very much. Appreciate mm-hmm. it. But yeah, we will go around the table, introduce ourselves and our characters for the evening, with the exception of Glenn, who will mm-hmm. just introduce himself, but not his character mm-hmm. yet. And then we'll do the recap and we'll jump into the fun. So mm-hmm. I am Don, and I play Ethier, the Grave Domain Cleric, in this one.
I'm not Lawrence, and I play Yalum Lo.
I'm Paul, and I play Felix Gray.
Stroke.
Felix Green.
I'm Gray.
I'm Glenn. Very good.
I play Glenn.
Len.
Glenn.
I'm Sarah, and I play Ritora.
And I'm DJ, and I play Nesgrim.
And I'm John, and I am the Dungeon Master of the City of Oshuamp.
I think you mean you're DJ and you're fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm fun. Oh, yeah, my name's Sarah.
Yeah.
Don John.
Correct.
Chat, the D stands for Sarah, the J stands for
I understand this is very confusing for you, chat. There was a whole thing in our D&D Discord last night. Don't be concerned. Don't worry
so
about
fun.
It even remotely. Mm-hmm. None of us got not enough
polisher.
Sleep. Don't worry.
Yeah, we all had sleepy ha-has. And it
don't worry about it.
I didn't check it. Yeah. So
it was great.
I don't blame you.
It's
was
a
very
scary
good.
Time.
Me either. I'm in the dark, too.
It's fine. I tagged Tom in something and he'll never see it. So mm-hmm. it's a good time.
Anyway, last time on Predators and Prayers.
It sounds like a courtroom drama.
The case of
dun, 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 dun.
Wait, no, bing bong.
Yeah, so Predators and Prayers. Ritora's owl, Juniper, came back towards the party with a small rat in her mouth. We saw the blackened claws and recognized that they were created by Frostbite. A strange telekinetic power removed the portions of the rat from Juniper's mouth. Ritora wrapped her hand and then removed the remaining muscle, fat, and sinew from inside of Juniper's beak, and Nesgrim stomped those pieces with his boot in the snow. Ritora cleaned her hand. Nesgrim didn't clean his boot. That's totally fine.
I mean, I've been walking through snow.
Uh-huh.
It would brush it off.
Yeah,
and
brush.
Mm-hmm. Maggots won't live in snow. What are they going to eat?
Snow?
They eat flesh.
Your
snow
boot.
Is... My boot? Oh, no.
Yeah, they're burrowing into your foot as we speak.
Sick.
That's fine, Paul, don't worry about it. That's a big no.
You're fine.
Okay.
He's not going to become some horrified, possessed monster and eat you in the night.
Whoa.
They journey over to Growlers and watch as a disgruntled group leave, dismayed at being told that the tavern is closed for the evening. We waited until those individuals left the street and then entered inside Growlers Tavern with Luna permitting us in. We walked into a bountiful feast on an extended table put together by two of our smaller rectangular tables. We looked in joy and merriment as it looked like real and delicious food, and Luna permitted us a chance to seat. As we sat, two women, after Luna called out for them, came out through the back door behind the countertop of the bar where the kitchen supposedly is. Supposedly. yeah, and it was a pair of younger looking women, one an elf, one a human, walked over gracefully and graciously, one pulling the chair out for the other, permitting her to sit down at the head of the table. The elf woman looks quite young for an elf, pretty tall, 6 foot, violet eyes, brown hair, well dressed. And then the other woman, lavender hair, bangs that mostly cover her eyes, and also well-dressed. I'll leave it at that, because this recap's pretty long, to be blunt. Yeah, we sat down, got started eating. Luna introduced these two women as Faye and Grace, two of her best friends and accomplices. Nesgrim tried to flirt again, and it went as expected, saying that he was fun.
Just want to be clear, usually I'm not trying to flirt, it just turns into that.
It's fine. I'm proud and honored that it happens with me. Truly a cherished experience.
You should be the only one.
Oh, Mr. Nesgrim!
Oh, Mr. Nesgrim, come back to my bone dungeon.
Oh, no.
Dungeon. Yeah, so we got...
Kind of like a bone basement.
Correct. We started eating, and then began to ask Faye some questions after she had introduced herself to us, stating that now that we have associated ourselves with Luna and begun to do some kinder things with her, that she felt it was necessary for her to introduce herself to the party. We asked about Widow's Wail, her relationship with Corrin, and the experiences that she has had herself inside of the city. She tells them that she has assisted in the research on Widow's Wail, and that as far as she understands it, there is a few pockets of locations in which she and the others are aware Corrin collected some blossoms of it from, as well as other herbs that were required to make the ailment that they provide. They also asked about Adrian, his life while he lived outside of Slums West, because he did not grow up here, and this is not his first shop. He previously worked in the Aderos, the center area of the city, known for being the area in which the elite nobles reside. He was also involved there in herbalism and apothecary work, and was connected with Faye's family in the Aderos. He, however, was eventually dismissed from his position working as an apothecary because he became fanatically obsessed with the Defiled and other occult things. I will say entities, because we are unsure as to what the Defiled is.
It's always a great clarification.
Yeah.
To make.
Yeah, it has a body. It's fine. it's not already inside you.
That's why he's green.
Yep.
Concern.
Mm-hmm.
Big concern.
Yeah, Mr. Nesgrim.
Bigger concern.
The seraph is already crying within you.
DJ's going to start crying soon.
Uh-huh. It's fine. Yeah. So Faye confessed that her family was the ones who occupied the herbalism store in the Aderost, and that she was permitted brief opportunities for study at the academy inside of the Inner Sanctum, the innermost portion of the city of Oshuamp, and she feels as though accidentally, as a younger girl, during her fun studies, might have accidentally divulged information to Adrian that spurred his obsession with the occult. She also reveals that her family was invested in the ritualistic uses and the various qualities of Widow's Wail, and that the effects of it are directly correlated to the individuals who died in the area and the Widow's Wail bloomed from. She believes it requires something more than just flesh or blood, because she has experimented as she exposed her palm to the party, that there is a scar in her palm, and says that blood is not sufficient. Aether begins to posit that it could actually be leeching the soul of the individual as it seeps out of its mortal coil. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine, DJ. You didn't die.
Totally fine.
Wait, what?
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 We listened as Aether, after she unveils a little bit more information about the various herbs that Aether uses, when he offers her his small flask, or his vial, that contains the substances that he utilizes. She informs him of their names, their other uses, and Aether becomes a little bit more frightened by the fact that he's been using shit he doesn't really know about. He just knew what he was educated by from the shamans back in his hometown. As they discuss the value for what there might be in a substance like this, Faye simply looked at us and asked, "Can you think of no one?" Our conversation about Corrin himself resulted in a confession that he is a paladin and serves with an oath of redemption, trying to right the wrongs that he felt guilty and responsible for in his life and at his death. We also discussed the notion that if the individual if the widow's wail is correlated to the person who died, that this might be the explanation for why it was capable of healing Nezgrim from the necrotic issues from that wonderful bite in your neck. We learned a little bit more, I guess, about Nezgrim as he regaled Faye, Luna, and Grace with his visions from his death and from his horrific nightmare. Faye told us that the little bit that she was exposed to during her education inside of the Inner Sanctum is that the Defiled was rumored to be an ancient horrific monster that plagued the areas near Oshuamp, and that some scholars believe that Osador's crusade was as much against the orcs that claimed the city as well as the vile earth around it. We then concluded with... First, I guess I should remind everyone that she revealed that this city is not actually Oshuamp, but indeed a city built atop the ruins of Oshuamp, and you guys correctly and wisely connected that to the cathedral that you encountered below the orphanage. We learned a little bit more about Faye's history and her time in the orphanage as a child after being banished from her family, after she was outspoken against them upon discovering what was going on with the Widow's Wail, its occult connections, and her guilt with Adrian being the way he was now. While she was stationed in the orphanage as a teenager, assisted with caring for the children, mostly the infants, and while she was there, it was still under the directory of Sister Sabrina, who she called a very kind, loving, and motherly woman. Faye, after a couple of years there, confided more and more with Sabrina, eventually dictating to her that she felt that there was something more nefarious going on, not only in the Aderos, but in some higher parts of the city, possibly connected with the Inner Sanctum and potentially the cathedral itself. And Sabrina, distraught over her sense of service and duty, said that she would go to speak with the officials and highest ranking members that she knows of, and left the orphanage, leaving Sister Isabel temporarily in power, and Sister Sabrina never returned. And last thing, you guys told her about the vampires. She told you guys that they are correctly called vampires. You brought up Nina.
Yep.
Again,
that was a good move.
Told them that you're an Osimar. They
also a good move.
You know,
I can't. Good. Yeah, I can't tell if that's sincere or not.
I mean, it matters. I'll say it matters. and they told you that you, as an Osimar, would have had a delectable blood that would have been well valued in making a poultice in the Aderos.
They sure did.
Yeah.
They can't kill me. They can try.
You already died.
I didn't even have the confidence to finish saying it.
As they can't kill me, but they can't kill... Oh, wait, never mind.
Kill you and make some Nez juice.
Oh. Some out of my Nez grapes.
Yes. Squish him. Well, guys, it's been fun. Yeah. It's been great.
Gotta go.
I left my dryer running.
We talked a little bit more about Aether's visions in particular, the herbs that he utilizes and the function in which it performs. We connected the similarities between a few of the herbs that Aether uses to what we saw Adrian using in his basement. We got some new names of some terrifying herbs that the party connected to, possibly having some kind of deeper meaning. We relayed the horrifying guttural scream that Nezgrim heard in his vision, and she told you that that sounds, as far as she has studied in descriptive quality, that that is akin to Abyssal, a language spoken by demons and other fiendish creatures, and that there was a possibility in what she studied that could be a connection to the Defiled, as though it might have been an ancient demon that you have heard speak to you in your nightmare. I love Dungeons and Dragons.
Because if it was real.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Oh, you... wait, we're talking about Dungeons and Dragons?
this was just...
Yeah, this was just you. Right
okay. Yeah, she informs everyone that the Defiled's true name is Lost, connects this to the reasoning for why in Oshuamp and in the majority of this continent, worship is done as the faith of the nameless, because naming is directly related to the power of the individual receiving the worship. Nezgrim is even more terrified because of the black claw, and Adrian is a prophet of the defiled and totally had a black claw tattoo on his back.
Sure
so,
did.
You know, shit's cool.
I didn't tell him I'm an Asimar, but it's not like he doesn't know.
Oh, I think all those times when he said you have a most delicious soul, that might have been my hint that he tasted it. He did say genuinely he likes the way you taste,
he
Mr. Nezgrim.
Like, he did indeed.
That was not a sentence like I wanted to have to say, but Adrian really wanted to say that.
Well, it's good to know that I've got the upper hand in negotiations.
Yeah. You want to taste me?
That's going to be my new Tinder bio.
You don't want none of this.
My Nezgrims. Oh, Jesus. Ether concluded with talking about his vision of the orc skeletons inside of the cathedral, dictating the golden coins that were in his in their hands, dropping them, and repeated the phrase, Oshuai Wampu. She connected this for us to the meaning of the name of the city of Oshuamp, having been shortened from the orcish phrase after having been reclaimed by Osador during his crusade. And Aether is afraid that it might be the true name of the defiled, but Faye wisely disagrees, dictating that it doesn't mean in orcish something that would be akin to a name, and tells you that it instead means haunted gold. And we will begin here. Still sitting around the table, the 5, 6, 7, 8 of us, 9 of us, because Leo's still in Luna's lap, the 9 of us sitting around the table.
Haunted gold? Like cursed gold?
I mean, I think there is a difference in a haunting or a curse, sir. Is there not?
I suppose so.
I believe a curse would indicate that something imbued it with a bit more of a desecrated or unholy power.
There's also something that could likely be reversed, whereas haunted gold sounds more permanent.
Indeed.
Okay. That's not not very good.
No.
How did the gold become haunted?
We do not know. We don't know even if it necessarily is haunted. Some individuals who have returned from the mines clearly have brought something back with them. However, others have come back just as they left.
I'm assuming this is not common knowledge.
It is not. Should the people of the city know that there is something more treacherous inside of the mines beyond the obvious threats of the monsters, something that would follow them home, it would be difficult for the city to continue to function economically. That is usually why individuals in the Aetherost hire adventurers to go into the mines, not employ themselves.
So they're baiting people in to get fucking haunted?
I mean, I don't think it's necessarily that they want the adventurers to be haunted.
They assume that they will be haunted.
I believe they assume there is a high risk or possibility of it, and that is why they require all of the gold to be handled and touched before they take it from them.
Okay.
Do I imagine the people who take these contracts are not aware the gold is haunted?
No, they are not. Some say it is the greatest secret of the city of Oshuamp.
I would say so. I have seen a lot of things. I have not heard of haunted fucking gold in my 10 years.
No, it was only something that I overheard from a meeting with my parents and another noble in the Aetherost, as they were attempting to procure a sufficient party for the coming spring.
Has anyone gone into the mines with that knowledge?
I don't honestly know. I can't say for sure. I believe there are probably some who have been informed of this fact beforehand, and probably simply didn't handle the gold themselves either. There are ample laborers in this city.
Now, were any other cities reclaimed the same way that Oshuamp was? Are there any other areas that were...
Oh, Mr. Nesgro. Reclaimed, you say?
Or, you know, that a similar... any other cities taken over by force?
Indeed. Several throughout history. Wars with the monstrous, uncivilized races have always plagued our lands, even south of the wall.
And some of that land, of course, then had to be taken back.
Correct. I'm going to genuinely have her make a history check to see whether or not... Okay. Map time. Because, to be blunt, some of them are different time periods, and I have to connect them to what she studied.
Gotcha. If that's the thing that you just want to...
No, okay. I like know it, but I want to make sure I look at the map and make sure I give you the correct ones.
I'm amazed that you even know it.
Oh, for the... Again, this is why I said Oh, I'm a fucking idiot. I can just go back to my world history page. World timeline, page. Lore, and name meanings.
Oh boy!
This goes so deep. Mm-hmm. There's so much.
Did you assume that it didn't?
Snaps for the DM.
Well, it's ruin it all.
Golf claps.
Ruin it all.
Jazz hands.
For cities that were conquered and reclaimed, Ryek was not so named before. It had an orcish name.
Is Rarfly one as well?
Rarfly? I do not know much of this city. That name is quite peculiar, though.
Do you know what it means?
It is orcish, but that is not one word. It sounds as though it is a pairing of words.
Rarfly?
Correct.
What do you know what those words mean?
I do, Mr. Nesgro.
Great.
Sacrifice on the sand.
Oh my god.
None of these places have happy names.
Do you know how it got that name?
Probably from sacrificing individuals on the sand, Mr. Nesgro. I do not know much of this city.
Like a desert?
Perhaps. I'm not even sure where this city resides.
Where is the city, Nesgrim?
In the southeastern corner of the continent, I believe.
Correct.
Although, I don't believe Nesgrim would know that, right?
I mean, your parents would have theoretically told you, yes.
So, yeah.
Is it by the shore?
That wouldn't be something that they would have told you.
Right, yeah.
And you left as an infant, so...
Yeah, so I wouldn't remember anything.
Yeah, I wouldn't justifiably give you a chance for, like, a history check.
I'm sure we don't got a fucking Leviathan situation again.
No. He's something much greater.
Can't wait for that to be an episode title.
Guess what, fuckers?
Episode 148. Ah, shit.
Leviathans, damn.
We have one already.
Okay, so Horiak is one. Do you know of any others?
Of cities that were conquered and reclaimed?
Yes.
No, there were orcish raids that went further south, but I do not recall any of those cities reported as having been conquered.
Okay, and what was the orcish name for Ryak?
I do not know, sir.
Okay.
I know only from text that it had an orcish name.
Understood.
The great city of Endemar was assaulted about 1,000 or so years ago.
What was the city name?
Endemar.
Endemar.
Mm-hmm. Elvish for something. For, well, I think everybody but you knows, correct? I'm assuming one of the four companions would tell you. It just means the center of the world.
I wonder where it is.
How literal is it?
Map!
What do you say?
Yeah. Conceited elves.
Is that a little strange?
Far too zoomed in. She wouldn't know the result. As well, there was an orc warband that went east to a different woods.
Okay.
I sadly do not know the result.
Orcs usually attack cities, do they not?
They do indeed.
Why would a band of orcs attack a group in the woods?
Again, I'm not certain, sir. My studies were only a few years before I was no longer welcomed back. Well, I know only that they, after retaking Oshuamp, spent several decades reforming an army and marched south of the Felrost. And some went west, some went south, and some went east.
Okay. So we had... I believe I talked to them before about trying to replicate what Korn... Was that Luna or was it everybody together that I spoke to about that?
For replicating what
Korn did in
with
his
the dirt?
With the Widow's Will.
With the dirt specifically? Yeah. I mean, yes, that was in correlation to why she said it requires more than simply flesh or blood.
Right. Okay, that's right.
And that was where Aether posited that it might be something connected with the soul.
Right. Okay.
It seems your interactions in the city would require a bit of assistance. And she just kind of looks over at Luna, who still has the chicken leg. And she just nods, and you watch as she lifts her leg and Leo slides to the side, and she loudly stomps her boot on the floorboards. And Glenn, you hear a loud stomping on floorboards above you, indicating to you that you know to ascend the stairs and open the door from your room.
I guess I head towards where the stomp came from.
Yep. So you ascend the small staircase, open the door, and you find yourself in the familiar setting, as you know, is the kitchen behind the bar.
And I can hear... There's a few people in here still.
Correct. Yeah. You can hear that there sounds like a few more people than what you are typically used to when you are invited upstairs.
Between the stomp and when... I'll do it later. Never mind, you're fine.
Mm-hmm. With this glaze of malaise in my eyes, I just kind of, okay, guess. And just start to walk out to where the stomps came from and where she was calling me.
Very good. You open the door. And you may describe, as you begin walking towards everyone, what you look like.
All right. So pretty much the door will creak open from the kitchen into the main dining area. Mainly, you just see a humanoid figure. Roughly average height, around 5.5 to 6 foot tall. Sort of walk through the door, hood up. As I kind of approach a little bit closer, you can kind of tell that I'm not quite... white human. It's a little bit of a slight snout, slightly small, like larger eyes than you would normally see.
Some more prominent,
and that some bigger teeth than you would.
I feel like I've heard this snout? Description before.
Dressed as a grandmother.
Why'd you have to make that canon?
We need disguise.
It's a really good disguise.
It really is.
And just... too real. Patchy facial hair. and I just sort of approach cautiously up to Luna to, like, just past, like, where everybody's sitting, not to really kind of be a part of it.
Sure, so you would like to be standing a few feet away?
Yes.
I'm just staring.
This is another of our acquaintances. A man who has provided us with services over the years. Something that I believe you all may now require.
Now, when you say man, you mean...
Man. Introduce yourself.
My name is Vorst.
Hi, Vorst.
Hello.
Hello.
Forgive him, it's still an adjustment period.
What services did he provide for you? Did he sniff out the enemy?
Well, he is experienced and quite physically fit to do more laborious tasks, as well as has a bit of a familiarity with places that you all might find yourselves in sometime soon.
Say, Vorst, are you good at digging?
I have a shovel, yes.
Shit.
How is he with buffing tables?
Actually quite good as well. Our finest table buffer.
How does Luna react?
Luna just immediately, like, giggles a little bit, looks down at Leo, and Leo's like, I don't get it.
Have I ever seen bones that may have been shaped similarly to this?
I mean, he
on
looks
my
like
adventures.
He looks like a humanoid question. Figure. Oh, I mean, man, he funny. Looks like a man. It sure. is more that his physical details look peculiar. Again, in terms of the patchy
peculiar,
hair,
you say.
Yeah, the patchy beard, the pronounced canine teeth.
Yeah, that's more what I'm trying to get at.
The little bit of a snout. There's... Have you seen skulls like this? No.
Okay.
Not from areas north of the city in which you have explored.
Even better.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Delicious secrets, Paul.
I rolled history.
Okay. 4.
See if I have ever seen or heard about anything like Vorst.
Okay. What was your history check?
23.
You correlate his appearance to what you recognize from textbooks. I will text you. I gotta bait everyone in, Paul.
Nesgrim.
Yes?
I don't suppose that you've ever seen a man like this? Perhaps in...
Ryak.
Ryak?
Did I?
You did not.
Did not?
Oh. Bless you.
Thank you.
God is strong.
Yes, I'm not sure if...
Enjoy your delicious secret, Paul.
Even more peculiar than
share
you, Nesgrim.
No, why not? Because it's so much more fun.
That's right. And you don't know that he knows anything.
Dun, dun, dun. Yes, I've never seen a, wolfman before.
You must have wonderful bones.
I suppose
most do.
You do have bones.
Yes.
And I'm sure
I
they're wonderful.
I've never seen someone that does not have bones, Nesgrim.
The appearance of my own bones has not come across my mind.
Well, welcome. Now
it will now.
Protect your bones.
I'm Retora.
I will protect your bones.
Hello, Retora.
I am Aether.
What lovely introductions you all are.
You have.
It's fine.
When I look at Luna, can I tell that she's, like, comfortable around these people?
Yeah. In terms of, like... You know she would not have introduced these other people if she did not feel comfortable.
Okay. Just on the basis of I don't know if she called me up here to talk or to go to work.
Uh-huh.
So...
I'm going to remain away from the table.
Yep.
Do we have to pay him?
I would anticipate perhaps a percentage of what he assists you in acquiring might come find its way back to Growlers.
Like a headhunter's fee.
I mean, I wouldn't say that he is a headhunter.
Well, no.
Would you say that he is not a headhunter?
I wouldn't say that he's not a headhunter either.
Fair enough.
Vorse, do you hunt heads?
You see, things happen sometimes that you just...
This man hunts heads.
That's
are these heads fair. That you... We've, hunt, don't we've do claimed hunt a head or do so. Not hunt?
We didn't hunt them.
Are they deserved?
I do what I'm told.
Okay. And I trust in your...
Judgment.
Yes.
Of course.
Then I trust you. Hmm? We will get along very well.
Mr. Vorse is quite a helpful man. See, our reputations in the city are not always most well received. As for reasons as to why we stay where we are and do not often venture out of Growlers.
And if he is going to join us?
Vorse's reputation is a bit more fresh and blank in this city. You know of him?
Good.
Are you from the city?
No. Not originally.
Where do you come from?
I come from the woods.
which woods?
We have several from There's... several woods.
Give me a name. Give me a name.
Stop touching your face, Paul.
Would you tell them? Because I'll remind you.
I have it listed. Okay.
Trying to figure. Yeah.
Ask me later.
I'm glad the table caught it, though.
Mm-hmm. My tablet caught it.
Yes, Force history is mired with some difficult experiences. And that is what has led him here to us for sanctuary. And in return, he does things that we need in moments of tribulation.
So what would you like him to help us with?
Well, you all seemed quite interested in the herbs that Adrian uses.
Indeed, yes.
And... knowing that only Adrian or individuals in the Aetherost would have these to sell, and that Adrian now, knowing enough about you, I believe would have a hard time pressing him into his private wares.
I would agree. He would likely not sell to me.
Nezgrim, perhaps?
I was just
certainly Nezgrim.
Mr. to say. Nezgrim?
He might give them to you for free.
Would he sell to me?
That's true. However, I would much prefer to not go there alone, as I'm not convinced he's not going to eat me.
I don't think he would eat.
You're not going all there of you. Alone.
Just the soul.
Just that.
Sister
if you are truly that. Afraid of Adrian, I will come with you if you need be.
I would definitely need some people with me for that, yes. And I'm sure Adrian would have no problem telling someone with such a delicious soul as mine what information he has.
I think we should not go back to Adrian.
I fear for the payment.
What is the payment in that
trip? Oh, ample supplies of gold.
Oh, well...
He might also look... at your soul again?
Well, that's what I was going to offer as payment.
No.
Okay, great.
No.
That's perfect. I'm he sure. already has one of those.
Does he do that often?
Yes. What so frequently.
How often
enough.
I can't buy this
brand. How many times?
What?
Don't. die.
I'm not trying to die.
It sounds like you are. Do you have a death wish?
Don't go back to the bad soul man.
He has information. I want that information.
You should let me know. I will stop trying to revive him and wish to die.
I'm not trying to die, I promise.
Just want to sell my soul.
I have worked very hard to keep you alive at this point, and I kind of feel like maybe that's not what you want.
I don't...
Oh my goodness.
I don't believe that Adrian would claim your life.
See? Totally fine.
Completely I got
fine.
It.
Correct.
No insight needed.
He would claim your death.
Oh.
Yes.
Claim your soul.
Yes, yes, he would claim your soul.
Yes.
Oh, great.
Yes. That
fuck
is the...
that plan.
Again, yes, why I am saying it would be quite an arduous decision.
Yeah. I'm not going to do that.
The herbs, though, that you would require are expensive, as I said, because they are in treacherous locations. However, our friend Vorst here is familiar with some regions of it.
Of the woods.
Indeed.
Someone that is familiar with places that I have not been would be welcome. I am familiar with a fair bit of the area outside of the city, but not the area in which you speak.
Where have you traversed?
Mostly south.
Right.
Of what wood?
I'm just saying south of, like, the city.
No, you've gone north of the city, Dom.
But not all the way to the woods.
You've gone to the lower regions of the Fellwood.
Oh, I thought you told me that I hadn't. Okay.
No, I told you you have not, like, again, the Fellwoods are hundreds of miles
sure.
in length. You have only gone a short ways
okay.
in.
Okay, got it.
I have ventured briefly into the northern woods, but only a short distance.
Which woods, sir? There are several.
The Fellwoods.
Yes, those are not the woods that Vorst called home.
Vorst, what woods did you call home?
Yes, Vorst. The lower region of the woods of Nerinter.
Nerinter?
Ten.
From what you would have studied, it would have been very minimal because those woods are so aptly named because it is a shortened portmanteau of Never Enter.
Never Enter? And what are the woods called?
Nerenter. Nerenter.
Sounds like a safe enough place to
yeah.
be.
That's where I'm from.
Let's go.
Clearly, Vorst has survived.
Not without cost.
Cost? What cost?
It is still quite recent for him. I would ask you to please respect his troubles.
And you believe that he can guide us into this place that he is unwilling to speak of?
Well, it is always Vorst's decision. We may ask things of him, but should he feel the threat of the woods looms too high, we could attempt other methods of assisting you in procuring these herbs.
If I take a look out the window, what is the weather like today? So in terms of the evening, yeah, you would go towards the window, and I think you would just instantly, like, recognize what's happening. This is where it starts to taper off, I believe I said, yes. Because okay. it was heavier snow earlier, yeah. so this is where it begins to taper off.
So it's starting to slow and snowing.
Yep, and then it overnight becomes, like, flurries, and then it's quiet for several hours overnight.
I keep doing this, and I don't think everyone really understands what exactly I'm.
Mm-hmm.
You know those glass jars
mm-hmm.
that have the weather in them, where it like rains in the jar.
Oh yeah.
That's almost
gotcha.
What I'm like
mm-hmm.
like a
Like a biotope.
Orb. Yeah, correct. Like a little orb of weather.
Felix, a question for you. If liquid freezes and you're always slightly wet, how long can you be outside before you begin to freeze?
I've been wondering that same thing.
I won't freeze?
Maybe it's
you don't
like
freeze?
Humidity.
And additionally, what color would you turn?
This is a very good question.
I poke him.
What do you get when you mix green and blue? What color?
Nezgrim, you take one psychic damage.
Worth it.
As for the locations of some of these herbs, two of them do sit in regions of the woods of Narenter. As for the third, even I do not know where my parents procured it from.
Which ones are you? Which are which, I guess?
For herbs that I know in the woods of Narenter, Fleshwort, and Mordain. However, the berries of a bloodberry bush were difficult for even my parents to procure.
Can you describe them?
Mm-hmm. Gotta go to that herb page.
I will ask so many questions about herbs.
A bloodberry bush is a small shrub with obviously red, alluring berries. And then the leaves are heart-shaped with a green center and red along the ridges.
Oh, that sounds pretty.
Doesn't it? It's toxic.
Most things that are pretty are.
Pretty toxic.
Aren't you?
I giggle.
You said you know not where they came from?
I know for the two in the woods of Narenter, they are more along the central regions, stretching a bit further north, beyond because where you were.
These berries that you describe, I don't think I've seen them myself, but I have heard of them.
Have you, Vorst?
Small red berries, heart-shaped leaves.
Indeed.
Do you know where to find them?
Not the exact location, but I know where to look.
And where is that?
Not a good place to be.
Oshuamp is not a good place to be, and yet we're here.
Many places Oshuamp are not a good place to be.
Is the safest place I've been.
My perhaps world just shattered.
Yeah, Force has seen some shit.
That's terrifying. Mm-hmm.
Do you believe that you could guide us to these bloodberries?
I could.
And will you?
The problem lies in returning.
Okay.
In what sense?
Just walk back.
Those woods are just treacherous.
That's what we have Nezgrim for.
To check for traps.
I understand.
Very observant, Nezgrim is.
Very resilient.
I just shoot him a thumbs up, wink.
And I could see, like, he's kind of scarred up, right? Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. 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 What's poking out of his armor? Mm-hmm. Yeah, he looks haggard.
Rough.
Yeah.
Recently. Recently, so.
I love the same thing of you.
You look like you've taken a hit before.
It's very good at
That's
it.
That's an understatement.
Yes.
Several.
Can you fight?
Not well.
You did very well in that duel.
You're a good boy.
that duel that you definitely needed to participate in.
Mm-hmm. You almost stayed standing at the orphanage.
It was close.
Yes, and in the basement I almost stayed standing as well.
Almost.
Maybe you should stay here.
No, he should come with.
We need someone.
All the help we can get.
Yes, I agree.
They have a word for that. I can't remember what it is.
Bait?
It's something that gets in the way when you're getting attacked.
Scapegoat?
Shield?
Something like that.
Meat shield?
Meat shield. No, the woods where the bears reside is... It's... I know the woods very well. Well enough to know that... Anyone who goes in there now... Probably won't make it out.
What are the names of... What's the name of these woods?
Narenter.
Oh, the same... The, okay, that's where the bloodberries are? Okay.
Yeah, I thought the berries were not in the narrative.
Or we just
woods.
Didn't know where.
She doesn't know where they are. Okay. He is saying that he can connect them to a further, deeper location into those woods.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. Understood. Okay.
How long would it take to get there?
In terms of what you would know back to where you lived, it's like 8 hours, and you are uncertain as to how far deep into the woods you would need to go. You would probably, I would say, estimate based on your... hunting and traveling experience, like a day.
Whew.
Yeah.
It would probably take a day with the weather and the beasts in the wood. I don't...
Oh yeah, if you guys want to start begin traveling, we can travel.
I'm not sure that that's the safest idea as of right now.
It's up to you guys.
Luna, how much ailment do you have prepared already?
You mean, like, how many barrels?
Yes. Like, how long would you be able to last on the supply you have?
Corin just delivered, like, yeah, like a 10-day. Okay. Maybe a little more. Depends on how many people are sick. I don't know.
Understood. Okay.
Depends on also if you're going to need to keep coming back and, you know, if you're going
to
need it.
I'll do my best to
not have Corin.
Luna?
Yeah?
Clark said he may need some more. And he would like...
That's right, the basement lady.
The tiny one, point to Leo to deliver it.
You know Clark?
Yes, we all know Clark.
Does everyone know Clark?
He's a good man.
That he is.
Very good.
Do you know Clark?
He's the BBEG.
No.
Clark.
He's an evil man.
It's time to pawn you.
Oh.
I know Clark very well.
You've not been in Oshuamp long, and you've already met Clark.
I imagine a great many people that need things have met Clark. He seems to be someone that, especially in the less fortunate part of the city, that people may interact with frequently. And given our friend's situation and nature, it is not so surprising to me that they have crossed paths.
Okay.
Mr. Nesgrim, have you been in Oshuamp long?
3 days.
4 days at this point.
4 days.
4 days?
Four.
So I was unconscious for 2 of them.
It's really trying to balance out that ratio.
It's 50-50. In real life.
It's 50-50 right now.
And you all, 4 days in Oshuamp?
Only the 2 of us, or 3 of us.
I've been here for 10 years.
5 years.
5 days.
You three have much to learn.
Indeed they do, Mr. Vorst. And I believe that they can be valuable assets to us in the future.
If you say they're okay, I know I trust you.
Of course. As a... Well, I do not want to feel as though you are pressed to make a decision. The herbs are something that it doesn't seem dire for you to acquire, but there are many things going on in Oshuamp.
Would we likely be able to make one trip to collect them all?
Okay.
Um, Yeah, in terms of the fact that, like, I would say that she just did genuinely dictate to you that she knew of the two, and he has now connected the third. It might be more treacherous in terms of his might be further in, but don't know.
But I'm going to start eating.
Okay, very good.
If we were to go after the herbs before the 10 days up, so Luna, how long does it take to prepare the element?
Oh, the fermentation process?
Yes.
3 days?
So we have 2 days to prepare if we are going after these herbs.
Time there, time back.
Yeah. Correct. So time, it's one day there, 1 day back, plus however long we spend in there.
Actually searching.
Traveling. And like, then 3 days for her to make it within before she runs out at the end of the 10-day.
Correct.
So we have roughly like 1-2 days to prepare.
Sure.
Is that something we would like to do in a couple days? Because if so, there's some preparations we should probably make.
I'm going to pull out my change purse and just count how much.
For example, my armor is quite damaged.
I have to take care of Juniper as well. Is.
She could come with us. Though in her current state, I am not sure it is wise to take her further into the cold. Perhaps we can look for someone who is more adept with animals and healing them.
That might be for the best.
You got a sick pet?
Yes, my owl. I think you have met before.
Oh, the little white.
Yeah.
White one.
We went out on bit of a hunting trip and came back with a frostbitten legs and a bit of an unsavory catch.
Unsavory how?
Maggot rat.
Oh.
Ragged net.
Oh my, maggot rat.
Yes, we pulled of it out of its mouth, but...
Is your owl alive?
Yes. Currently.
I haven't read its owl obituary yet.
Right. Kill it. See you guys later.
This is two today now, DJ. This is two. First one right after midnight.
You
now.
Wonder why you keep dying in this game.
You know what? I'll just put in the psychic damage myself.
I'm not going to poke you. I laugh at it. I just wish that I could silence you.
Me too. Dal is alive, right? Not dead.
Currently. In my tent. Sleeping.
Perhaps they could look after the owl here. Since no one will be in Aether's tent while we're gone. Perhaps Clark could look after it as well.
You need someone to watch your bird?
Ideally, yes.
And Luna just kind of looks down at Leo. Bring the bird! Fucking fine, bring me the bird. It'll sit, fly, do what birds do. You know, bird shit. You're gonna clean up the bird shit, Leah. And she's like, that's fine! Don't put the bird shit in the bread. No, never. I swear to God.
Has that happened before?
No.
Break open the bread.
So I don't even need to.
It's happened before.
I mean, some people use it as on their skin.
Yeah, to put shit on your skin. Shit skin.
Knowing what we do about haunted gold, the gold that was given to us by Arthur was in a bag. We have not skin-to-skin touched it yet.
Oh, I have. I put it with my gold.
Oh, Mr. Ethi.
Step out into the moonlight.
Have you had any bad dreams recently?
No.
Okay. That was earlier today, wasn't it?
That was just this morning.
Oh, yeah, right.
Goodbye.
We
I do not sleep very much anyway.
I'm just worried that perhaps the gold he gave us is also haunted.
I think perhaps it may just be currency.
It could just be gold.
It could be. Perhaps you were given cursed gold, and that explains why you have seen worse shit than I have ever seen.
That's
and
I
look at the skulls of people that I have found in the cold, and that is the worst thing I have ever had described to me. So,
it was rather terrifying.
It was quite scary to experience, believe me.
Well, I'm glad that I'll get to fucking take a look at it when we get these herbs.
Yes, speaking of which, we are going to get these herbs, yes?
Yes, I think so. We need to help Luna. I do not wish to leave her in a situation in which you are not able to help the people of this city. The work that you do is very good.
Yeah, thanks.
Are you coming with Green Man?
I suppose. Well, we need to be prepared.
Yes.
Of course.
Luna, do you know anyone who would be able to repair my armor?
Repair it?
Yes.
Or
at least mend it so it's usable.
Yeah. Oh, you go to Christian, that guy's an asshole.
Well, I don't want to go to an asshole.
No, we should go there.
Why?
I would love to see you interact with someone described like that.
You can offer to buff his table?
You are so happy and cheery.
Buff his forge.
He might be into that.
Adrian was quite into me, yes?
Yeah, I'm into it.
Okay, it's set
hot up. Commodity.
We're going to see the dwarf, man. We also have a something that he needed.
Come on, Nesker, might he gotta be the worst? Mm?
Someone is mugging my customers, and now no one will come to me shop, find this bastard, then I'll give you 6 gold. Perhaps we could go talk to Christian, make gold in the process of repairing your armor, and
be a little more prepared for this journey?
Yes.
Yeah.
And if someone is mugging someone else, we could mug them.
Luna, what an interesting group of people you've made me.
Yeah, I don't really fucking like them, but I mean, they...
Well, we like you.
You know, now that you mention it, Ether, if someone is mugging other people and they turn out to be particularly bad, we could feed them to the earth.
I told you all.
I warned you.
It's a bit of a strong jump. It's just, I'm mugging
just
is bad.
Just connecting the dots.
Okay, I
never
agree.
Know. I'm not saying for sure, I'm just saying
no,
he's a potential
understand.
Candidate.
I mean, as far as I'm concerned, any bad deed is not worthy of crossing the river. I don't know that I would jump to feed them to the ground, but...
what do you do with dead bodies but feed them to the ground?
Well, they're not going to be dead,
like
is
a metaphor,
what I'm
really.
Saying.
Well,
we're not
be...
going to go up to them, hey, you have mugged this shop, and then they fall over dead.
You never know.
And we shove them in the ground.
Well, if no one sees us,
what
then yes,
give
that's
them
what
a heart
happened.
Attack? Oh, perhaps okay. They are scared
would
of bone
I know
men?
Anything about this?
Or green
like the ground being fed? Would I have any inclination as to what that is talking
nope.
about?
In your eyes, we're a bunch of murderers.
Mm-hmm.
It's fine. Just people that deserve it, same as Luna asks you to take care of.
That's where they go.
That's where all people
Dude,
go.
Dude, it's fine. They're fucking weird. We're all fucking weird.
So, Vorst.
Someone's gonna end up in the ground anyway. Go ahead, Zari.
How far away is Ether's tent from Growler's?
Only like a 10-minute walk. It's not bad.
Yeah.
It's nighttime. You'd be going alone.
No.
Nope. I'll tell you that.
I will go with you if you wish to go get your bird. I am very familiar with this part of the city. I have moved around at night before. I know the streets to avoid.
I would like to collect him.
Okay.
As soon as possible.
Mm-hmm. That's right, it is nighttime, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Come on, Nesgrim.
Oh, okay. Oh. Here we go.
I guess you're all leaving.
Well,
we are just going to get the birds. We will return momentarily.
I will stay.
Very good.
I will stay as well. I think with Nesgrim, they will be just fine.
Very good. All right, see you three later.
Okay. Goodbye.
Oh, I just can't wait till they open the tent. There's 6 people in there.
Oh, great.
Half a TPK in bed.
Just remember, hooty hoo.
It's what the owl says.
Yes.
They leave?
Yeah. So they get up, they excuse themselves, they leave.
Is he going to be all right?
Any of them? No, probably not.
You mean Nesgrim?
Yes.
Especially
he'll,
not.
He'll be fine.
Just kidding. He seems fine.
He's totally fine. He's totally fine.
Okay.
Into Felix's mind. He's definitely not fine.
I respond, definitely. No, certainly no, not. He's so
100%.
Fucked. He's so dead. Does he even have a soul? I don't
the
know.
The most fucked.
Now that some chairs opened up, I'll come and sit down. Mm-hmm.
I'm going to ask Faye. Faye?
Yes, my friend.
Do you have any of the books or writings of what you studied?
No, forgive me. They are at the Academy in Cesti in the Inner Sanctum. I was not permitted really to withdraw books from the library. I was only permitted to briefly enter and be given access to read them while I was there. Yes. Truly, it feels a lifetime ago now.
So no notes either?
No. Forgive me. Those would have all been left at my home after I was abandoned.
Okay.
As for your interest in these herbs, Vorst has told us of some harrowing tales, and I warn you that should you encounter any of these creatures, do your best to flee by whatever means.
What sorts of creatures are we talking about?
Would you like to Vorst, or would you prefer I tell them?
You can say. Just sort of kind of look off.
Mm-hmm. Vors people lived, as he said, in these southern regions of the woods of Nerenter, an area plagued by orcish raids. A small band of people found it very difficult to stay safely in one location, having to change dens quite frequently. Able-bodied, though, they were able to defend themselves sometimes, and in others, forced to barter with the orcs. Supplies, foods, furs. However, recently, only a few years ago, he told us of a harrowing day in which a different kind of orc arrived. One that bore spikes adorning its arms and legs. A pair of curved black horns atop its head. And a short, barbed tail. It seemed as though it led these orcs. And it, as opposed to the others that were ravenous in their rampages, this one seemed a bit more gluttonous and did not simply kill the people. Vorst was able to escape with his life. However, we have not been able to ascertain if anyone else survived. And so, in his solitude, he turned to Clark, who directed him towards us. Should you see this spiked orc, I would not approach it, and do all that you can to flee. However, it only appeared once, and none of us have any idea as to why.
Are there other creatures other than orcs?
In the woods?
And there is only one orc like this?
That Vorst saw that day, indeed. The other orcs were not so horrifically constructed, I suppose you could say. This one stood several feet taller than the others, and... well...
it sounded like nothing else I've ever heard.
Yes, a horrific, guttural scream.
Like,
and, correct.
Nezrim made?
Correct. And we are unsure as to what this creature is, or what its purpose might have been. We know only that it descended from the mountains to the west of the woods. So we are unsure as to if it was making its mark or simply feeding. But the woods are large, and should you move quietly, I believe there is a fair chance of success for you in passing through. Vorst would know where to avoid, should they have claimed the lands of his people.
Okay.
Do you think that Nezgrim is capable of moving quietly?
No.
He doesn't seem like the type.
I do not suppose you have any suggestions for how we could make the table buffer move a little quieter?
I am unsure. The only recommendation I could possibly have is that he travel a bit lighter. Instead of the heaviness of his armor, he might pass a little more quietly without it.
He might actually die without it.
Indeed. However, he might die without it. You all might die should he wear it.
Fair enough. Suppose we can try to talk him out of such a choice in attire.
Indeed.
I do not suppose that this Christian could provide him with something similarly suitable to keeping him alive.
Christian does indeed sell other armors that Nezgrim would be able to wear and provide moderate values, but Christian is a interesting man. You'll be fine meeting with him. He is not dangerous. He's simply loud and a bit confrontational. Good man, though.
Fair enough.
What do you think of all of this? And I'll look across to Grace.
To Grace? So you can see that she is just slowly kind of cutting her food. Now, as she looks up when you use her name...
make a constitution saving throw.
And...
deck save. She throws chicken leg at you.
Yeah, she just kind of looks up and you don't really see... her eyes, like I said, the extent of her lavender bangs kind of cover it. And she just looks up in your direction. I think anyone that willingly goes out into the woods in search of something for what you all are looking for has a death wish. And she just kind of lowers her head back down and begins cutting her food again.
Okay. I'm gonna start cleaning up the plates
for them.
Left.
Yep.
You don't believe that there's any chance of success? Or...
she just kind of keeps like her head down and you hear her voice, you know, very like faint, like a whisper, but has a serious tone still to it. I think you can... succeed, but success is hard to measure, and I believe the cost might be more dire than you all are thinking. As Vorst has said, this city is the safest place he has been. I think he means that.
And the cost, should we not retrieve these herbs for those that require the ailment?
I think the individuals who plague this city with their good intentions, and you see kind of like the flicker of a smirk come around the edges of her lips, might find themselves in a better position in the city. The less of us there are, the easier it is for them to oppress. I would not like any of you to die.
I would not like to die?
I should hope not, sir. Each of you, I believe, will be, as Faye said, valuable assets in the pains of the future. There are many things in this city that need to be cleansed.
Of course.
Now, Faye, I know we've talked about this briefly, and to keep things short.
Of course, Vorst.
The berries, the plants.
Yes.
The fleshwort and the mordrain, you know where to find.
Indeed.
And the bloodberry I have heard about.
Indeed.
Nothing I've ever laid my eyes on. But as you know, it is ramblings of a fever dream.
Indeed.
Could it... they're real.
I have seen my parents receive bloodberries, and I have watched Adrian use them for more than just his visions. And I believe that that is what frightens me more than just a vision.
The procurement being difficult enough as it is, the location in which they would be found is just... there's no way to tell for sure where.
I have been reluctant to tell you, Vorst, but that mouth you've seen. There is a possibility of a connection to something that I have heard of.
If you're willing to share in front of new company, by all means.
If they're willing to make the journey, I believe they deserve the knowledge.
Troublemakers are at this table.
When you've described this fevered dream to me, the things that you have seen reminded me of an ancient tome I was permitted to study, and I have, over the years since you've arrived, attempted to correlate them with rumors from past explorers. I believe you saw not into just the woods of Nerenter, but into woods slightly further north, where few dared to tread. A treacherous and terrifying region.
pits or this place of horror. Essentially the last thing that's... Some of my people, the last thing that they've seen is real.
Indeed, Vorst. I believe that the other orcs who plagued, in a more literal sense, your people, might have been contaminated with something.
Now, would I have knowledge of the rot outbreak and...
Not of the rot, and the stuff in which I described to you would not, based on what other people like might have said in passing, would have visually correlated
not
with
similar
what you
enough,
correct.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, the progression and the visuals would not be the same.
When she mentions woods further to the north,
mm-hmm.
would I correlate that with where Corrin was going?
No, opposite side.
Opposite side.
Correct. Fellwood, east side, woods of Nerenter, west side.
North of Nerenter.
Correct. So it would be the northwest ones, whereas Corrin, you know, would be going to the northeast.
These woods have a name that few know or are willing to utter. And this is, again, why so seldom do travelers ever go to this side. Loggers and other hunters stick to the Fellwood for its safety. It is not just orcs that plague the western woods. Further north from Nerenter, I heard a man say that he overheard, as he returned, attempting to find valuable trees that were known for the quality of their wood in the production of magical items, that he heard a gruff orcish voice say, Krugodge.
Would I know what that means?
Yep, I'll message you.
We heard Buck say that once.
Correct.
And I forget the context.
In terms of an area in which his people wanted to try to go towards, approached, and got terrified of and left. Like, genuinely went that direction thinking maybe we could make this a home for ourselves and said,
That is what the woods are called.
Krugodge.
Krugodge.
Krugoj.
How was it spelled again? Sorry.
Krugoj.
Big oof.
Uh-huh.
And you said that there's wood from the trees?
Correct.
That can be used for magical items?
In the production and creation of magical items, yeah, as though it is a very valuable and rare tree.
If that is truly the resting place of these herbs, it would make sense as to why their procurement is so infrequent and their value is so high. Again, that is why I do not believe even should your friend Mr. Nesgrim go with his good connections and his liking of him. I don't believe Adrian would be able to part with those herbs without sufficient payment. It is no simple task to go retrieve these, but if you all believe that they are necessary, I will do what I can to support you, and I will, should you spare me some of them, do my best to research should there be other options for their use in perhaps a more medicinal or beneficial way to us. And again, you would be paid.
if we are going to make this journey so far and into so much danger, is there perhaps anything else of value we could keep an eye out for that you are aware of?
When Forst has told me of this fever dream that wounded members of his tribe suffered, they spoke of a mouth of a cavern, of splintered bones poking through dark, blood-stained soil. And this is where I believe the flesh wart can be retrieved, amidst those bones. And the Mordain grows nearby. I believe it grows out of the black pools. However, the bloodberry bush, should you have seen it in your fever dreams, it appears it grows in similar areas. However, the mouth of that cavern is not something I would cross that threshold of. A horrible, lurking creature is rumored to exist within.
What sort of creature might this be?
No one has returned to tell tale of its appearance. But Krogodge means webbed mouth.
I don't like spiders.
That is my assumption as to what the creature may be as well. And nor do I.
Not big ones, at least.
Yes. And I fear its toxins are what might have plagued Vorst's tribe, instilling within them those fevered dreams until they died.
How long ago was this?
Not long. Not long ago at all, really. I arrived in the city about 2 years ago. It's been quite a trip here. But in my travels in the wood, in my lifetime living with my tribe, some of the horrors that we've seen, some of the things that were described in these fever dreams were just terrifying. Going back to these woods will not be an easy thing. Going in and retrieving what we need to get will not be easy. Returning will not be easy. The last time I tried to make it out, we didn't all make it. Not sure if anybody's still left, really.
And yet you survived?
Barely. Yes.
How many were in your tribe?
60 or so. So, you can see where the difficulty lies with returning. My personal pack, my family, was 5 strong. Left alone, we would have surely died. Without the help of my people, I would have not made it to here.
So then we have no choice if we go. We have to be quiet.
Indeed. I would recommend that. It is, again, no small feat, but I believe the rewards for the procurement of these herbs and other items, should you retrieve more than what you require for yourselves, we could fence on your behalf to either Adrian or other herbalists that we know. And again, you would be handsomely rewarded. This city thrives on ambition, but it sustains itself on patience. Your travels need not be a hurried one, for if you begin to move too quickly through the woods, you may awaken things that you didn't want to. I will do all that I can to assist you, but we need to remain here in this city to assist those that we keep who are more vulnerable, properly protected.
The degree of finesse and survival that would come with us making this journey is just something I don't think we're capable of yet as a unit. If we're going to move together, we all have to be on the same page, and, well, I've only just met you. And your friends who just left, they seem like there's a little something that needs to be worked on.
Whatever, I genuinely laugh.
It's
that obvious, huh?
Yes. What I've gone through, the things that I've seen, the training that I've undertaken. I don't look like that guy.
Just that one.
Whatever could you mean?
Very well.
There are other things you may find more suitable to attend to. As I said, the herbs are there and shall be. Traversing out into the woods in the snow is not a decision to be undertaken lightly. However, with the assistance of your friend with maintaining weather patterns, I believe that is a boon that other travelers typically do not possess. She may be vital to your survival.
I certainly know a few times it would have helped me running errands for you.
Indeed. Forgive me, Vorst. Sometimes...
All is forgiven.
Sometimes it gets a little more hairy out there. She visibly chuckles, and you can see Grace, like, kind of lightly, like, not snort, but, like...
kind of shoot her a look, and then, like, kind of crack a smile, because I know she's just fucking with me. Mm-hmm.
Can't Luna?
Yes.
I don't fucking want to help that guy.
She has her own sense of humor.
Just sort of look at Luna and just smile.
I think it's funny when you come back all snowy.
I know. You always feed me.
Yeah, feed you. It's food. Looks down at Leah. Yeah, the bird shit.
Shut up.
She just kind of like pats him on the head. He's like, I'm just kidding. He's kidding.
I shoot Leo a look, just like,
I'm so sorry. Grace's seasonings, you know, over. Whelmed any other components of the dish.
Not all of them.
Do There are many things, though, that we could use your assistance with. And should you all decide to change your minds and do something instead, please feel free to return and ask Luna to meet with us. Vorst, whenever you would like to come home, you are always welcome. But I believe these individuals will need your assistance.
You've only led me in the right direction this far.
Thank
you,
Vorst.
Why would I stop trusting you now?
Thank you. Do you guys have anything else you would like to ask any of the people here before I swap to them for their discussions en route and then returning?
I'm trying to remember if we asked about the rot. I don't think we specifically did. Faye, Grace?
Yes.
Were you in the Northern District when the rot hit?
Yes, we were. And Faye just kind of looks like, I guess like adoringly at Grace. We were, I suppose you could say, still not yet established as business owners. It was after I concluded my time at the orphanage before my banishment. Grace and I took delight in stealing from some of the more, less savory folks. Grace is quite, well-versed in gaining people's favor. And I am able to keep her safe. We make a fantastic pair. But eventually our reputation began to wane, and as the rot started to set, we made a different kind of plan, one that would have given us a better opportunity to escape Slums North. Grace briefly returned home and came back with much fuller pockets.
Home?
Yes. Grace and I are childhood friends from the Aetherost.
Ah.
Yes, her family was well-regarded. Is well-regarded. As is mine. And after taking what she could and pawning some other items, we had sufficient money, and a good man, Noah, told us to come here to meet with Luna.
Noah's from the Northern District?
Oh, yes. Noah, the pawn man.
You mean Clark?
No. Noah. His father.
Oh.
Good man.
Would I have heard the name before? Like, would Clark have talked about him?
Correct.
And Faye would have talked about him?
Correct. Indeed. Noah was a very charming and benevolent man, and did not deserve the fate that he was given.
Which was?
Rot.
No. Noah was one of the men who were outspoken when Corrin was executed.
The fires.
Indeed. Noah and some of the other protesters were gathered up and boarded into homes. And then the homes were lit aflame.
By the guards?
Indeed.
Not the same guards that are there now. Surely.
Some might be from that era. I have nor his grace, nor Luna returned to Slums North since Grace and I made our exodus, finding our way here at Noah's behest and offering the money that we had taken from Grace's family to extend and continue building, providing us ample shelter below, and then continuing. And this has been our business, the three of us together, slowly accumulating other individuals that we believe are trustworthy and good-natured to help us in protecting those innocent, isolated peculiars like Forst here.
So, you fled while the outbreak was happening?
Well, the what was happening? I'm sorry.
The outbreak, the rot?
Indeed.
Did you see what they... Anybody that was cured, or how they dealt with the spreading?
No, and speaking to Corin after he began to recollect things, after his transformations, he recalled very few people that he was able to assist, Clark being one of them. He remembered there being a few others, but is not sure as to who they were. However, the dwarves that he spoke of, none of them we knew survived. However, Corin again was not there at the time of their death, so as to whether or not we can truly believe that to be factual is a challenge in its own regard.
Was this rot that you all speak of, was this some type of plague?
Something like that?
Indeed, Forst. Before your time.
Was it not of natural causes?
We do not believe so, no. We believe its connections to the mines, based on Corin's discoveries.
Perhaps the gold?
Perhaps.
I will look at the locket that is still in her possession.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she just kind of like holds it once more. And you said this was a belonging of Madeline?
Indeed.
Gifted by Desiel.
I believe it was given to her by... I believe she said it was from... Isabel and Sabrina?
You just see she just kind of like is slightly taken aback, and we're gonna pause you guys there and swap. Because that is an aspect of conversation where I think it is fitting for everyone to be involved in.
Also likely that they'd be arriving back soon.
Correct, yeah.
Of course they die on the way. We'll never know. There's a new button there now.
Call office?
Yeah, that cool. Flashes the lights.
Okay.
Some of the speech to text stuff is so funny.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm not surprised.
Yeah. One of them said, took a picture of it. It said, crab legs of a fever drain.
It's like so
those
close.
Those sound delicious.
It's yeah. So close on so many of the words, and then some of them are just, just off.
All right, I'm here to eat crab legs and buff tables, and I'm all out of crab legs.
That's muted. We're good. Yeah, so you guys exit Growler's Tavern. As you step outside, you see, you know, the clear skies above with small collections of clouds and the little bits of snow still lingering and falling over you as though it's a light snow.
Mm-hmm.
And you begin to make your way back towards Aether's Bone Tent. Okay. You come to the conclusion of the street. You see Guardsman's Highway, and you can see that it's a little bit more active as of right now out in the streets. You can see that there, it looks as though to the north of you, there are some guards
handling some potentially distressed individuals. You can't really hear much of their conversation. So they look like they're about 120 feet or so away from you, but you can see it's a pair of guards dealing with what look like three like older looking men, sure. Like 50 plus.
Humanoids. They don't look familiar.
No, not
for me. This is pretty expected.
Commonplace.
And yeah, okay. Yep. Which is what I was saying. Like, I kind of know the streets to avoid at this hour.
Correct.
And move my way around.
Yeah, and you swiftly direct everyone right across Guardsman Highway, right back to Grave Robbers Road, where your shop is on, and we make our way up the street.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can and Nesgrim and I definitely would have
ran over to help and be like, "Sirs, do you need help? Murderers!" And just instantly stabbed.
I'm sure Aether saw us be like,
"No, no."
Yeah, and I just like pulled you guys the other way. No, this way.
Okay.
Yeah, and you can see that as you guys are moving along, as you're passing along Grave Robbers Road, you can see that outside of the quiet night, standing, you know, right on the little dirt landing at the front of it, you can see Elisa kind of standing out there looking up at the sky.
Good evening.
Oh. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
How are you doing?
I'm all right.
Oh, we,
just a reminder, we haven't returned yet.
No.
Okay. I'm going to pull out the things that I've gotten for Benjamin.
Mm-hmm. The ball and the bunny.
Right? Yeah, the bunny and then the ball that I drew face on.
Okay.
And just kind of hold these out. These are for Benjamin.
I apologize for my behavior earlier. I hope that these make him happy.
I understand, Mr. Aether, and you can just see she's kind of like rubbing a tear out from under her eye. Truly appreciate it, sir.
Is everything okay?
Yes, Mr. Aether, everything's all right.
Insight check, please.
Yeah. Go right ahead.
18.
Okay.
10. DJ, are you going as well?
Going what?
Insight.
To see whether or not. I mean, it's up to you. Like, if you believe Nesgrim wouldn't socially pick up on any cues from that lady,
I mean,
that's totally fine.
She looks, you know, she wiped a tear from her eyes. She looks sad. He would kind of, you know, there's something going on. She's sad. Something must have happened, yeah.
So you gonna roll or?
No, okay. He would tell. He would go. Oh yeah, she's sad. Oh. I know she's sad.
Okay. So I mean, in terms of you would pick up effectively the same as what Nesgrim. For obviously visibly discernible, she looks slightly upset.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Everything's all right. Everything will be all right.
If there's anything that I can help you with, please do let me know. I would be more than happy to do anything that I can.
I appreciate that, Aether, and thank you very much for the toys.
Of course.
I do hope Benjamin.
And she just begins to, like, turn and places her hand on the door handle and opens the door and begins to step inside.
Is everything okay with Benjamin?
He's a good boy.
He is, yes.
And she just turns and, thank you all.
Good night.
And you can hear, like, the heaviness in her voice. She begins to close the door.
I'm gonna follow her in.
So you're gonna, like, stop her from closing the door?
Elisa.
Pardon me, Mr. Aether, what?
I'm sorry to, if I am overstepping. Are you sure that everything is okay? Is there anything that I can do?
No, Mr. Aether. Just another day.
Okay.
Is this something that I've seen before with...
No,
not at all. Okay. Just trying to discern if, like, Benjamin has ever had, like, an issue prior where she was sort of, like, upset in this nature.
Not in this context. Like... You've know, seen her before, kind of like, you know, this looks a little bit more like emotional distress.
Okay. I'm going to just kind of reach out and just like touch her shoulder and cast guidance. And just, if there's...
As you reach towards her, you see she just kind of quickly shudders and leans back. No, thank you.
Okay, I'm sorry.
No harm intended, I'm sure. It's all right.
All right, get easier. I think it's best we get to... I
apologize for disturbing you.
No apologies needed, Mr. Ether. It's just another day. You step out?
Yeah.
You watch as she just kind of closes the door quietly. Again, you can see like another tear welling up in her eye and begins to fall down her cheek. And you're all standing out here, outside of the quiet night.
We should continue moving.
Should get your owl.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. You pass quickly through the singular alley that has you arriving at the entrance to your bone tent.
Okay, before we leave, I'm going to just look at the outside of the inn and see if there's anything that seems off to me.
Okay, roll for perception.
18.
18?
Yep. Secret.
The secret is brought to you by Dice Envy.
That's a good one, yeah.
If you want your shiny, shiny math rocks.
Which you do.
Which you definitely do.
There you go.
You can get, what is it, 20%?
10%,
20%.
For which of us?
Dice Envy?
15?
10? We don't know. 10%. You'll save something.
10%.
Good. Money. And amount. Cash.
If you use our code.
Go to DiceEnvy.com, use code NGDC, get 10% off.
Got dice, need dice?
Save your cash.
All right, you've been gifted your perception check.
I'm going to kind of beckon to them and walk over to that side.
Okay.
And carefully peek around the corner of the building.
Okay.
To where that's leading.
You want to explain to them where you're leading them?
There are footprints on the side of the building along with a trail of her dress. I fear as though either perhaps Benjamin has been taken and she chased after them or something else has happened. There is not generally this much foot traffic around the side of the building.
Okay. Should we follow it?
At least to see where it leads.
Okay.
I can turn into something smaller if necessary.
That would be helpful if you would like to look. Yes. I think that would be helpful.
Just look out for large pale men.
If there is something that sticks out as being strange, perhaps we should get our friends before we proceed, but
yes,
worth at least investigating what is currently happening.
Have I seen any street cats or
You transform into a small cat?
Of course I do.
Very good.
Of course I do.
Yeah,
small cat, pretty fuzzy, like longer fur, all white.
Very good. I will permit you to, after everyone, if you would like to make survival checks to see if you can keep these tracks going, because I cannot genuinely indicate to you immediately how much time would theoretically have passed based upon the flow of the new snow. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel
these tracks might be slightly covered in certain locations.
Understood.
You also might be going in directions in which you pass other foot travel. What did you roll? Oh, boy.
Well, 13.
I swear 13. These rolls are never on my side when I need them to be.
Okay. Sarah, I will also permit you to utilize Keen Sense as a cat to roll for perception with advantage to see if you pick up a scent.
Bless. Bless that.
Mm-hmm.
That's a 10 plus. Kay. You said perception?
Correct.
Oh, yeah, right.
So this is for her specifically.
13.
13 for the higher of the two rolls?
As a cat.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, wait, two. So that was...
As a cat.
Correct.
So yeah, 13 is the higher of the two rolls.
Okay. I will message you what scent you pick up.
John, I can't see your phone, but somehow I still know you're typing Ambrosia.
Thank you.
Oh, why did I have to be right?
Mr. Nesker.
I was hoping you would just shake your head.
He did, but yes.
Yes, but actually yes. No.
Mm-hmm. So my fur definitely bristles up. Mm-hmm. My tail gets like...
bushy.
Don, you said 18 for the survival?
Yes.
Correct. Okay. So you can see that these tracks trail in, so you can see the footprints coming in from the north side of the alley, and you can see the exiting footprints as well go to the north. A single pair.
Okay. That don't...
Single pair in, single pair out.
Do they look like her?
No.
Okay.
These look like, you know... moderately sized humanoid boot prints.
So if somebody was taken, they were carried.
Correct. If that's what you want to assume. Yeah, absolutely. That would be my logical estimation as well.
If they were dragging, somebody would clear the footprints.
Or walking, like holding their hand type of deal.
Right.
We would know.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Well, he is certainly small enough to carry. Mm-hmm.
I do not think that we should follow these further. We should perhaps get our friends first.
Should we
come back?
At least find where they lead.
I would say for you, for your survival check, as you follow them out, it looks like they go straight across the street through the next alleyway, but that would be beyond the extent of your vision as to whether or not they would continue or go in a different direction. Like continuing straight or going left or right.
And where they're headed, is that in a direction that I would know to avoid at this time of night?
Not necessarily. You would know that this would be going in the direction of where Tattered Tomes and the Overflowing Barrel reside, and then there are obviously row homes and other
stuff
things
over there. Yes. Okay.
Are you going?
I think we should get our friends first. I do not wish to take the risk of venturing further into something that clearly upset Elisa a great deal. I have never seen her like this. I don't know.
The smell.
I did get
that
the smell.
Matters.
Could we at least follow it until the next alley?
I would not take that risk. We may be able to see more. There could be a person on the other side of those footprints.
Yes, we don't know how old they are. That's true. We might walk upon them. Yeah.
I'm going to look over at Ether.
Mm-hmm.
And then look up to, like, the roof next to that alley.
Mm-hmm.
Look back at Ether.
I'm gonna
look over to the roof.
I'm gonna look at the roof.
Uh-huh.
Do you want me to fucking throw you? Come on, I'll throw you on the roof if that is what you want. Truly, you can climb. You are a cat. But I will toss you. Okay.
Okay. On the opposite side, correct?
Mm-hmm.
So you walk through the small street, which Don, you know, is called Thieves Alley.
To get fucking mugged.
I can't get
mugged.
She's
a cat. Yeah, her equipment is absorbed into her form.
Mm-hmm. Never mugged a cat before.
Oh, Don. Give me your dollars!
Give me your cat dollars!
Okay. Give me your collar.
That's good. Good.
So you cross the like 35, 40-ish feet of Thieves Alley in terms of its width,
mm-hmm.
and then you climb on top of a small abandoned looking row home cottage that is adjacent to what you recall as Tattered Tomes. You may make a perception check. This is for vision, though, not for keen senses.
That's cat perception. Wait.
Do they have keen senses for vision as well? I wasn't sure whether...
No, I just...
You still utilize your perception.
Yeah, because it says here skills perception plus 3. So technically, my perception on that last one was way higher than I said. So it would have been a, for the scent, it would have been a 19.
19?
Instead of a
Oh no.
Oh, I get more out of that.
Oh yeah. Sorry.
Now
yeah.
you know what direction
Ambrosia,
the scent trails go.
Blood.
Balsamar.
Balsamar.
Should I roll for that sight?
Correct, please, yes.
16 for that one.
Nice.
No, wait, still, my perception is still plus 3. It's, so 19 for that one as well.
Hell yeah.
Oh, it matters.
That's terrifying.
Yeah. Okay, so as you are on top of this small cottage and you look out, you can see that the footprints that Aether had indicated to you were the individuals that were coming from the previous alley continue north from this alley, going straight across that final street. And then you now can see in the midst of all the other dirt buildings and horribly constructed shackles, you can see what looks like cobblestone streets in the northwest corner of the city. And you lose the tracks in the cobblestone.
Fuck.
Mm-hmm.
Aether, do you know what buildings lie to the north? Oh, damn it, I wouldn't know that. Never mind.
Correct. And Sarah, you are a cat.
I'm going to...
So she wouldn't have even told me, yep.
I mean, she can jump down and come back and relay the information. But yeah, I mean, in terms of just at this moment, yes, right, you are correct.
I'm going to jump down and... I'm gonna stay.
As a cat?
As a cat.
Okay.
One, because I like to.
Same.
And two, in case I need to be
a cat.
A cat.
Mm-hmm.
You never know when you'll need to be a cat.
And I guess I will... I'll just climb up onto, like, Nezgrim's shoulder.
Okay. You know Retora the cat is now... happily standing on your shoulder.
Nice.
Still a little poofy.
But... A little poofy.
Okay. Mm.
Two of you are standing here.
I got a great concern.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like that.
I got a lot of concerns, man.
Okay, Aether.
Big city.
Let's go get this owl.
Okay. Yes. Come on.
I'm on Nesgrim's shoulder.
Oh, okay. Here we go.
Yep. You step over back through the alley, passing in front of the carriage of curiosities, and you open the flap to your tent. You can see that Juniper is kind of still huddled up in the small tattered blanket that Aether had constructed for her. You can see that her eyes are closed and she looks like she is elevating and descending, and you hear a small, adorable little owl snore emanating out from her.
I'm gonna walk over and just, like, scoop her so that way she stays wrapped and attempt not to wake her up. Mostly familiar with birds and things. So.
You can make an animal handling check with advantage because, again, yes, you are familiar with birds. And two, she is asleep. Also, she's seen you.
19.
19? Yeah. You successfully, stealthily scoop her up peacefully.
Cool.
You have this adorable little owl rocking in your arms. Her little owl face just poking out. Little beak.
I just see Pippin, honestly.
Yep.
That's all I see. So what do you make of our new friend, Vorst?
It's going to be hard traveling with him through the city. I feel...
mildly, but...
I'll drop the cat
shape. Yeah. Yes, that's a good idea. He probably won't like you as a cat very much.
I'm not really what I'm afraid of.
I mean, I could be very distracting and use bones as a cane. People would likely look at me and not look at Vorst.
That's true, or Vorst may try to attack your cane. Possibly. Given that it's a bone.
I am wearing a fair bit of bone jewelry. I would imagine it is not that uncommon.
I just don't know how he's going to feel about bones. Maybe he'll have
adverse reaction?
Unavoidable attraction to them.
I will... bring one, and I will simply ask before I pull my bone out.
Should always ask before, yes. Do you think dogs like bones? He may want to chew on it. That's what I'm worried about.
Possibly. I trust you, the both of you.
And I walk over to the entrance to the tent in the cart, and I just start digging in the dirt.
Okay.
And I... pull out my sack of bones.
Right in front of the...
Who's going to look in the shadowy darkness under a fucking cart?
That's a good point. Who would look under a cart?
And I pull out one of the, like, longer leg bones.
Yeah, like one of the femurs.
Yeah, and just kind of, like, tuck it in my side along with my bag so that way it won't be seen, kind of, like, under my cape.
Okay.
And then I wrap it back up, put it back in, and smooth it over again.
Okay.
And just kind of, like, muss up the dirt so that way people won't know.
Yeah, look
there.
At it.
Yeah.
I didn't see anything.
I trust you as long as you did not mention it to anyone else. That is fine.
Those tracks... they went, continued north across the street and then headed over to the cobblestone part of town and were lost after that.
That is where the water house is.
Why would they... Okay.
Perhaps they needed someone small to sneak inside. It is just a theory. I'm not entirely certain what other buildings are over there, but... That is where the guardhouse, guardwater, and the waterhouse for this district is. It is entirely possible that someone is planning to do something in that location.
What would
the tracks smelled of flowers and also of ambrosia.
What kind of...
Okay, that's not so good.
What kind of flowers?
Just... Various wild.
I mean, yeah, I would just say wildflowers, like the sweet aroma of wildflowers.
Okay.
The kind that grow in large fields, typically.
Okay, don't like that either, given what I saw in my vision with Desiel. She was moving through something.
She was.
That was Desiel, right? That was, yeah, okay.
Where would there be... Why would there be flowers in this city?
I mean, it's not a crime to have flowers. I'm simply suggesting wildflowers specifically in a field is something that we are familiar with in concept in terms of someone right. that we murdered and crushed into dirt.
Guards like right behind me. Hey, buddy! I'm kidding.
Hey.
Also, just wave the button at him.
Hey, you know, hey. Me.
I'm more concerned about the ambrosia. It's the same smell.
Oh, yes, no, that is very bad also. I'm simply commenting that the wildflower scent is also not good.
Well, the ambrosia and the wildflower together, we know...
Is there anyone in the Atarast who...
We know the awakened smell of ambrosia, yeah. But why wildflowers?
Are there gardens there?
In the Atarast?
None of you know?
I am not sure.
I imagine there would be, right?
Probably, but...
It would be difficult to grow anything in this environment.
Yeah. Correct.
That's why it's so interesting.
I do not know.
Well, we'll tell everyone else what we found. I imagine if Forrest spent some time in the woods, he's probably good at tracking people.
They're coming.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah. You guys arrive back at the entrance to Growlers and open the door and find everyone in the
midst. Did it work? The lights?
Yeah,
cool. Yes. Going down to the bathroom.
I'm going to have to duck out of here in a second.
Yeah, I made it just do a little flashy boy. I muted yours, by the way.
Oh, good.
A little flashy flash.
Yeah, and
using the button. The
The three of you open the door and see all of your friends still sitting here at the table with Faye, Luna, Leo, and Grace. And you can see that they are in the midst of conversation.
And I would have taken Juniper from either.
Okay, sure.
Hi, friends.
I'll turn around and smile.
Mm-hmm. What was the last thing I said? Oh,
fuck.
Isabel and Sabrina.
Yes.
Was the last thing I said.
Correct.
And you said, she seems taken aback. That's where we're going to switch over.
Correct. Yeah. So as you guys open the door, you can see that there is this kind of like distressed, distraught look on Faye's face as she is holding the locket in her hands.
Are you okay?
What happened?
What did they do?
They said that this locket was gifted to Madeline by Isabel and Sabrina?
That is true, yes.
That's what she claimed, yes.
When?
It seemed it like she had it quite a long time.
Difficult to nail down a time frame.
Sister Lauren, I believe, said that she did not have it when she first started there, but it appeared shortly after. I don't know exactly how long Lauren has been working at the orphanage, but...
I'm sorry. But... Sabrina has been missing for 30 years.
Yes, we had gathered as much.
Yes.
The time frame did seem strange, and Madeline claims to see visions of Sabrina.
Visions
claims
of her.
To hear voices. It was hard to determine if it was whatever is ailing her or if it was genuine.
I don't fully trust Sister Madeline's perception of things. We know for a fact that she's been manipulated, at least somewhat.
It is entirely possible that that locket was given to her by someone else that simply told her it was from Sister Sabrina.
Maybe it was Desiel. Perhaps Madeline has no knowledge of what happened at all. It was all Desiel.
I believe she claimed to see Sabrina.
She did.
When it was given to her?
Yes, I wonder if that was an effect of the locket given to her by Desiel. Intentional.
She also saw Sabrina when she was looking out her window three days ago.
And while I would also question the certainty of Madeline's memory, we did in fact see Sister Amber in a state that would suggest that perhaps when these sisters are leaving the orphanage, they are not going where they claim to be.
I also have a theory. The herbs that I use and Adrian uses allow us to see things from people that are dead. Perhaps the dirt is similar in that nature, that you are able to see a vision of people that have died or perhaps been consumed by it. Perhaps she was seeing something, whether it was actually a spirit of some kind or not, I cannot say, but...
Or maybe a hallucination.
It is either that or a fucking ghost, I don't know.
Are you still in possession of the notes that indicated the names that Corin had?
Were we given that as a piece of paper?
You wrote
them
down.
He handed them to...
Yeah.
Ether specifically.
Correct.
And we did not give them back.
Correct.
That'd be the...
Not sure. I honestly think this dice might be loaded.
Really?
As I'm sitting here rolling it, it keeps coming up, not necessarily nat 20, yeah. But around
the numbers like adjacent.
Eight, like, yeah. Right around it,
possibly.
Yeah.
Possibly.
I mean, spent some time next to a flame.
I believe
flame,
that he
so
did.
Yeah, he did.
Actual possession.
Yeah. Yes.
That's correct. Now, I mean, I can also just permit you guys to make history checks in terms of the names that appeared on the lower podium of the statue from the cathedral. If you guys would rather that. If you don't, you have them all.
Yeah, we got
them. Okay.
He did give them to us.
Correct. So, yeah, it would be in your possession. That's fine.
Yeah.
So, do you remember them, or do you want me to tell you them?
We wrote them on there.
You did?
Yeah,
okay,
I wrote it on here.
Okay.
Despair... Grief, torment, agony, livid, and woe.
I do not understand.
The statue that Ether mentioned earlier?
The one that...
Moved?
Yes.
Yes, that statue. There were... names that appeared to be... inscribed beneath the statue? These names that he has just said?
I'll hand her the paper so she can see the markings.
Okay.
One of them...
Give me them real quick.
Sure.
One of them appeared to do...
She's gonna eat one of them.
Fade.
Do not say its name.
When Sister Amber fell.
Jeez.
I believe that perhaps they are connected to these vampires that you have told us exist in the city.
Did we connect one to,
to Amber.
We connected one to Amber, and didn't we connect one to...
We made a guess as to one connected to Carolyn.
Yeah, that's...
Correct.
Yeah.
Because of the location in which you found Sister Madeline stumbling through the snow at night.
Claiming to be looking for Carolyn. Right.
Correct. These notes are terrifying.
Oh, yes, they are horrible.
Scorched earth?
Mm. Like fire?
Indeed.
She is.
We did see...
out of character. We did tell them that we fought vampires, right?
Yeah.
Cool.
That's why she told you what they are called.
Cool. We did see one of the one we fought beneath the cathedral.
Amber.
She did not react to flame thrown at her feet.
Mr. Nesgrim?
Yes.
Mounds of clay.
This clay is surely a desecrated prison, was that it?
This clay is faintly a prison.
I don't remember.
The unflinching eye?
Oh, fuck.
What did you do? What did you do?
May I see this?
What on earth did you do?
Which name was this?
The unflinching eye and mounds of clay is agony.
Yep, I would have guessed that as well.
Well,
Oh, boy.
What have you guys gotten yourselves into?
I don't know what the fuck...
Now, when you say you guys, you are now a part of that, yes?
So now it's what have we gotten into?
No. You can keep your agency. It's okay.
Welcome.
He is joining us, I believe.
Visibly alarmed.
Back to Paul. He wanted to see them.
As you should be.
Shooting glances back at the ladies. When you touch those,
you do realize you are a part of this, yes?
I'm not touching them.
And boxes of scorched earth? Have you seen anything like that?
Boxes of scorched earth?
Indeed. We have seen dirt, yes. Or what appeared to be dirt.
What about like a fireplace?
Perhaps a fireplace, yes.
I cannot think of anything else that is a box that is scorched.
Unless it's not the box that's it's the earth inside.
The fucking hole in the ground that you took a nap in? That's a box?
I will indicate to you that this is her asking because she doesn't know these things.
Right.
It's sure. Not necessarily like everything that has been dictated in there have been things that you guys have encountered
yet.
I'm fine with you guys theory crafting, but like, just remember that would be my indication.
Yeah,
to
it's
you
not always you're... something mm-hmm. that we've correct. Seen already. Yeah.
You found these in the old cathedral, you said?
Corin.
Corin's basement?
Found them.
No, Corin found them.
Corin heard these things.
Heard these things.
And then found these names inscribed near where he heard them. He gave us these notes before he left.
Snacktown? I thought you were going for Snacktown.
I gave my parents my car key.
Oh, okay.
They have to go try and see if they can... Bring my
save
car
the
back
car.
From the brink of death.
Sarah's car is cursed.
Mm-hmm.
It's true.
Make it death saving throw.
It's already failed one, so.
No,
we got one success, one failure.
Keep rolling 12s.
Mm-hmm. Good
so there. I'm concerned that this is
also not
become,
well.
Become warped
mm-hmm.
from rolling it so
it
much.
It has become cursed.
It has become cursed. No, it's fine.
Well,
it just really likes to roll 12s.
I am confused, though, friends, for... They announced the death of Sabrina, and there was a
ceremonial burial.
Did anyone see the body before it was buried?
No, we were not invited to the burial.
Okay, so she's probably alive then, perhaps?
They said that she had contracted something.
The rot?
No, this predates the rot, Mr. Nesgrim. They said that she had grown ill. And
did they give a description of what she looked like?
Sadly, no. It was a public announcement made during one of the pilgrimages of the brothers, several years after she had disappeared, claiming that she had worked in a studious fashion in the inner sanctum, having been offered a position as an educator in the academy.
Do you know where they went on their pilgrimage?
What, the brothers?
Yes.
Oh, they go through the districts, east, west, and north.
I did not know if you meant they went out of the city somewhere.
No, they do not. They do not journey outside of the city.
Another question. What do you know about wildflowers? Fields of wildflowers? Are there any near here at all?
Fields? No. Seldom do plants grow in this part of the world. There are some that are capable of surviving in marshes and swamps.
Can you think of any nearby, near Oshuamp?
Or any reason that someone would need to collect wildflowers in bulk? We noticed when we were out retrieving juniper footprints that led away from the Silent Night where we currently stay, and the tavern owner Elisa seemed very distressed. And Ritora smelled ambrosia and wildflowers. And we came back here rather than investigate further once we lost the footprints as they went north in the district onto the cobblestone portion, and off of the dirt we were unable to track it further.
Stories my parents would tell me as a child and other books I read as a young girl. Flowers are given as a sign of affection. Are they not?
Generally, I would say so.
I mean, I know that they have other meanings, but a bundle of them presented to someone sounds either in a method of apology or a demonstration of affection.
Affectionate or condolences, maybe.
Perhaps.
She did seem rather distressed over Benjamin, but she would not elaborate further.
Who is Benjamin?
Her son.
Why do you say it like that?
I went out on one of my journeys into the cold and came back a few days later, and there was a child that she had, and she did not wish to speak about it, and she spoke in a sense of he had always been there, did not make a big deal out of the fact that he was there.
How old is this boy?
How old is he?
Like 5?
Yeah, approximately like 5 to 6 years old.
About 5 to 6 years old.
Mm-hmm.
That's strange. I don't know what to make of that at all.
I do not either, but I have never seen her this distressed.
Get out of here!
Every time.
I know, it's so random.
Have we told them about the encounter with the brothers? Or with the awakened? Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Luna.
We told.
Luna, I told.
Correct.
Oh, okay, so
in her mind.
Correct.
Not in
out loud
fashion that they would have been aware of.
Correct.
But I did caution Ether against speaking of it,
mm-hmm.
because he started to bring it up.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Okay, so no awakened stuff. Good.
I did mention the ambrosia.
Correct. She didn't comment on it. I will remind you of that.
I will not push it further. As I don't know that they know we murdered some religious men in the basement of this building.
Self-defense.
We.
Mm-hmm. Self-defense.
Mrs. Grimm did it.
Mr. Ethier.
Yes.
You say you travel outside of the walls?
I do, from time to time, up until... This is really the first year that I have spent any significant amount of time in the city walls due to unexpected guests that are trying to get themselves killed.
You don't say.
I have been mildly delayed in my expeditions.
So you're familiar with the Fellwood then?
Mildly, I have ventured a short way into the Fellwood. No deeper than about an hour's journey.
It's fair enough, they are treacherous woods. I must say, I'm quite impressed. Not many choose to do that.
Thank you. It is something that I feel I must do. I try to help those that cannot help themselves, in the sense that they are no longer able to make decisions as to whether or not they wish to turn their lives around.
So you could say that you and Luna and Faye and Grace are all kind of working towards the same goal, correct?
In a sense, I would say so, yes. They are healers and protectors of people, and I am protectors of souls. So in a way, they protect the people while they are alive, and I protect them after they are dead. And it is an honor to do that.
So, about the herbs. What preparations should we take before going?
You can't walk around in that, for starters.
Should probably find you some quieter armor.
Probably, yes.
Maybe we can pad it. Wrap it with something soft.
There's probably an easier way.
Luna, do you know of anyone who might be able to muffle this armor?
Y'all got an armor muffler.
If you tell me.
Breastplate stretcher.
If you tell me, I might buffle your table.
Buffle?
The old muffler.
I look away because I'm afraid. I'm afraid of what's coming.
I just put my head in
her tissue.
I shield my eyes when I'm about to
spit
hear.
On my tablet.
I'm so sorry.
It's so perfect for Nezgrim to have said, it's fine. It's so perfect, DJ. Let me buffle your table, please.
Yeah, I don't really need whatever the fuck that means. I've never had someone offer to buffle anything. I would never, ever let you buffle anything I know, or anyone I know. I guess I'm at least glad you asked first.
Yes. Nezgrim just...
But I still need my armor muffled.
You're gonna have to take it off.
Yeah, they're definitely amused. Like, you can see Grace is, like, visibly smiling, like, and kind of laughing, like, into her hand, like, the back of her hand. Faye is just kind of, like, holding at her cheeks, looking up towards the ceiling. And Luna is just like, what the fuck, man?
Nezgrim,
what about Leo?
Leo is just like, I don't get it.
Have a roll. It is okay.
Okay.
Here you go.
Thank you.
You enjoy that.
Just gonna eat my roll.
Yeah.
I'm gonna grab some meat off the table.
Christian's cool, I guess. Kind of a dick, but, like, he'll do whatever.
Again, I do really want to see that interaction. I would love to go meet this person.
Okay.
Wait, if you... he's meaner than you?
No, he's not mean. He's just a dick.
What do you mean?
You'll see.
Oh, shit.
He's loud. He's gonna love you, though. He'll never leave you alone.
Yeah. All of us?
All of you.
Oh.
Okay. Really, really affectionate guy. Weird ways, though.
Great. Not weird like Adrian weird.
No. He doesn't want to, like, touch your bones.
I look immediately.
Yeah.
There's a difference between Adrian and what I do. I just want to have their bones when they are done with them. If they need them, I don't want them.
I mean, yeah.
How many dead people still need their bones?
Not many.
Yeah, I think that's his point.
How many boneless dead people have you run into now?
None.
Yeah, that's actually a solid question.
I don't think I've seen a boneless dead person.
How many are after boneless he's dead? Done with them?
They're not boneless originally.
They're really a person when he peels the skin off of them?
When I'm done with them. I'm
visibly alarmed.
Yeah, right. I fucking would be.
Speaking of bones, great question. How do you feel about them? Is there any type of trigger?
Is that maybe an attraction of sorts?
I did not say that. That was entirely his discussion.
How do you feel about bones?
Speaking of bones, how do you feel about them?
Are you attracted to them?
I just need to know what your thoughts are on
them. What kind of dinner talk is this?
Right?
Well, that's what we're trying to figure out, is if he wants a bone for dinner.
That is what... Listen... I have said no such thing. Oh, these are the words that you have said on our way back.
Correct.
I said nothing of the sort. This is entirely his way of approaching things.
Yeah, presentation with your party member.
I simply...
Minus five, yes, Graham.
I simply wish to ensure that there is nothing that will affect you negatively if they were to be around in more of a presence than my jewelry.
With some of the carnage I've grown up witnessing, shouldn't be too much of an issue.
Okay.
You're not just... going to want to chew on it, are you?
That's what I thought he was getting at!
That is what he was getting at.
That's what he was getting at!
No, I thought that's what you were getting at.
10, huh?
Yeah. Right. 10.
Okay, so I'm going to pull out
a
long leg bone and just kind of set it on the table in front of me.
It's fine. It's clean.
I pick it up and...
No, it's not. I grab it out of there and put it back to my side. If I walk around...
What the fuck are you guys doing?
Planning.
Preparing.
For what?
Dirtying this table that I just...
This is very clean.
Oh, you buff the table.
Get to work.
What do you think I do here?
Yes, come on.
He buffs the table.
Come on, buffler.
I did your job yesterday.
Buffler?
Yeah.
Did I just do your job?
Why the fuck are you showing him bones?
I figured that if I walk around with this, they are less likely to take notice to our friend.
Make a deception check?
It's not really a deception. I'm not lying.
I mean, you were drawing him in for a question as to whether or not it would trigger him as an individual.
Yeah, but I'm saying that the reason that I want to walk around with it is to
They're
distract.
Asking you, like, what are you doing with asking him
this? Oh,
like,
oh, oh.
What the fuck are you doing right now?
Are you trying to, like...
Okay.
Like, you literally went, hey, is this going to be a problem for you if I have bones or if we see bones?
Okay.
Are you going to do something?
That's Yeah, because that's how I took it.
Sure.
Correct.
Okay.
That's how I
did it. Not like... Go eat it.
No, that's not what I was getting at. I just wanted to make sure.
Yeah, I mean, so that's not a deception check. He told them what he was getting at.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Sure.
Right?
Yeah.
I mean, again, it's still like, I think specifically identifying the individual and saying, like, are you going to have a problem being around bones? I think there's an intent to that statement.
Sure. I mean, I'll explain it. I'm not trying to deceive them.
Sure. Like, I just think saying, like, oh, I was doing this so this way other people wouldn't look at him, they would look at my bones, is not correlated with directly asking him, like...
I thought that's why they were asking, like,
no,
why
Luna is like,
why
the fuck are you waving a bone at this guy?
Sure, I misunderstood.
why are you asking him, like, hey, is this going to trigger you?
Sure. Okay. I misunderstood the question.
No, it's okay.
I thought they were asking him, why are
you asking him? They're asking you, like, why are you asking him that? Like, what the fuck are you doing to our associate? Like, this guy is our employee. Why are you badgering him?
I apologize. I am not trying to badger him. I am trying to be respectful. I do not know Mr. Forst very well. I
mean, why do you think Bones would bother him?
Bones bother a great many people. I do not wish to offend
him. And you said he had a hard road to Oshuamp. It's possible the sight of Bones would be traumatic for him.
Yes, I do not wish to
Then maybe don't
someone.
Show the thing to the person.
Well, he indicated that it would be fine.
You showed him it.
Yes.
And asked.
No, after. This I had it.
He did.
Okay. Yeah, I pulled
you got
it
a fucking problem. I thought you said, like, hey, how do you feel about Bones?
No, no, no. I only pulled it out.
He said, it's okay, and then he pulled it out and set it on the table.
I thought you were indicating that you were pulling it out as you asked.
No, him. I asked before. Okay. This was a segue from, hey, Bones?
Y'all good with Bones?
Like Bones?
Sure. What about now?
Fair. Okay.
Yeah, no, I'm trying to make sure, respectfully, that he's okay with it before I pulled that out.
He's assaulting me with a bone.
Yeah.
You good with this?
Yeah. Like, that's 100% how I took it. So I was like,
yeah, no,
am
no,
I
no,
tough
no,
enough
shit.
To roll with the bone crew or what? Yeah.
Gotta get in the bone zone.
Yeah, for real.
I mean, no. In terms of respecting his past, yes, please, should things become a bit more emotionally arduous for him, give him time. If you do elect to go into the woods.
Of course.
If you do not... I still think it is best should Forst accompany you, so this way his familiarities with other things in the city may be
helpful.
His expertise, yes, may be helpful for you.
I would agree. We would be happy to have you join us, Forst.
Okay, friends. Do we have any more questions for them?
Hold up my bird.
Oh, yes. Your owl.
Yes, this is Juniper.
Of course. We could care for her. It looks as though she is a bit, affected by the weather.
We're from the Avith Woods.
The Avith?
Yes.
Oh.
It is much warmer there.
And they just kind of, like, look over at Luna. Yeah. They fucking sucked. Why do you think I left?
All right, no need for hostilities. And when did you leave, dear?
Officially about 10 days ago, probably.
Oh.
They are very new to the wonders of the city.
Indeed. That would explain a bit of your, unfamiliarity with things. I'm very sorry for where you have found yourself.
From what it sounds like, this is not the worst place I could have wound up.
Indeed.
Though probably the worst place you could have ended up by a carriage. If you somehow mistakenly ended up in the Fellwood, I would say you are probably in much more danger as a person.
I had to go somewhere it was harder to follow.
Well, yes, I simply mean that normal people do not travel to
Hard
the...
Hard to follow?
Fellwood.
Why is that?
That was a particular choice of words.
A very peculiar
very,
choice.
Very, very peculiar indeed.
I didn't
indeed.
Say it,
I
but
would,
yes.
I would say that as well.
Were you not... You weren't with us,
were you? He wasn't. Why do you... care about not being followed?
I may have seen some things that I was not supposed to see.
Such as?
Someone I trusted. Doing the very thing we were working against. Do not know how it is all related, but it is related to this dirt and to the widow's wail. Mm-hmm. but so far the connections I've made here have not given me many answers, only more questions.
Okay.
Questions of your home?
Of my home, of my former mentor.
Mentor?
Yes. God, it's been so long since I even thought about this man.
Dun, dun, dun.
Now that I've started checking to see, I've started rolling and keeping track of the results. Haven't rolled a single nat 20.
Very good.
They're cursed.
A man by the name of Delawin.
Delawin?
Delawin was your mentor?
Uh-oh. Looks like you two have some additional things to resolve.
We do know about Delawin because he was Desiel's brother.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's a fucking problem. No wonder she hated you.
Mentor was Desiel's brother.
Now, when you say mentor, what do you mean? Exactly? We are referring to the tea provider, yes?
Yes.
Did he, like, teach you everything that you know type of thing? Did you have limited interactions?
I mean, really, if you think about it, it's almost like you fed Nezgrim dirt.
True. Go ahead, Sarah. Explain yourself.
Yolumlo makes a solid point.
No.
She has saved your life a great many times, Nezgrim.
She kind of voted to him.
She may have been the one to.
I do not think that she was directly responsible for that. You have. Well,
I mean, it was Delawin's dirt.
She didn't put the dirt into
she
your
She may
cup.
Have helped him learn the craft of using
but
it in that
she
way.
She didn't decide to drink the fucking cursed tea.
Perhaps True. We should let Retora speak.
Retora. Please.
I suppose from the beginning, as everyone seems to be aware, the Avith Woods have been dying, is not quite the right word, have been plagued by this earth that we've come across here.
Scorched earth?
I fucking hope not.
I don't know if I would call it scorched. There's no fire involved. That's
Is it
In
blackened?
Terms of the visualizations, it is blackened.
Okay, great. So we've solved that fucking
no
riddle.
Fire involved. It's just something like fire.
Like a ghost fire. Like a ghost fire.
Like a person we've been she told is like fire.
Like it's fire, fine. She is.
It's fine. Maybe
it's haunted fine. Earth. I
wonder if there's a haunted gold. When his sister's eyes close. Call home, sister's eyes closed. There was something about fire in that passage too, wasn't there?
Mm-hmm. A sister's mm-hmm. eyes are buried, a sister's eyes are closed, a sister's eyes will open when Sabrina calls
that's
her
it,
home.
That's it, that's
so,
right.
So what about this earth?
It's been destroying my home for many years. What started slowly soon began to spread, and I wanted to fix it. I did not like seeing the home that I knew and loved getting slowly destroyed. But my family, they were strong believers that you let things be, that interfering with, you know, the works of the world around us would only lead to trouble, and they were very paranoid about my workings. So when they discovered that I was attempting to heal the earth, they gave me the option to cease or to leave.
Your parents gave you that option.
Yes.
Retora, remind me what your parents did again.
She does not know. I think we have fucking solved it, perhaps.
Again.
Why else would they want you to stop? If they are not at least involved in the cause?
It's difficult to explain it, but they... It was their belief system.
What did they believe?
To meddle with the workings of nature as they are happening only brought hardship. It was bad luck.
This is a great cover story.
I can only tell you what I know.
I know, I am not meaning to blame you. I am simply saying that it is rather convenient that your parents told you not to meddle in things that perhaps they were doing themselves.
From my perspective, they lived by that. We were reclusive. We did not venture out at all.
And what of Delawyn? Do you want to elaborate a little on your...
When I ultimately left, I wound up in Faerun, the city in the Aveth Woods, and that is where I met him, and I believed we had similar goals. He too was working to stop this spreading plague in the woods.
And what did he do that made you lose your fondness for him?
After working together and aiding him to stop this spread, and making what I perceived was progress in doing so, technically Juniper found him, presumably sucking the life from the earth itself.
What?
How?
He blew the dirt right off it.
That's fucked.
Oh, that is fucked.
There is one other person we have seen that has done some fucking strange stuff like that as well.
But how was he doing it?
I don't know.
His hands?
Eating it?
Do you want me to just dictate for you?
I don't have the specifics of his actions.
So in terms of what she saw, he, in areas where the ground was not desecrated, like, placed his hand and the grasses would part and desecrated ground would rise up.
Okay.
And then he would siphon that, almost like pulling sand into jars. Sand, but like just small grit, like the silt.
Okay. So the healthy earth would be put in jars and it would...
No, he'd separate, almost like spanning the tides effectively, where the grass would part and then the blackened, desecrated soil would elevate.
And then he would pull
it into jars.
Okay.
If you wanna, for the ending.
Oh no.
I caught him selling off these jars to some cloaked figures, not unlike those that followed us in front of the orphanage. When he realized what I had witnessed, he turned the entire city against me and essentially put a bounty out for me. So I ran. I stopped in a nearby town. I got followed there and knew that my only chance of survival was to make it to Oshuamp before the winter started.
So you have several months before people follow in your footsteps and hunt you in the city, is what you are telling me.
Not including the ones that were already here?
Yes.
And we don't know who they worked for. It's possible they worked for all who in the city requires need of desecrated earth.
My dear, do you know the last name of this Deluid?
I never asked. I don't have one myself, so it never seemed important. I do know he is the brother of Sister Desiel.
Indeed.
What is his last name?
Forgive me. I believe that you have met a man I didn't think was still alive.
Okay.
I'm sorry. He was alive and well respected even in Faorn when I left.
She looks over at Luna. Luna just kind of like offhandedly shrugs and shakes her head. I don't know who the fuck she's talking about, but I mean, I left a while ago when I was a kid. Again, I understand, but there was a man who taught me at the academy named Deluin. When did you work with him?
I worked with him for nearly 20 years.
When?
Most recently, 11 days ago.
So,
I guess
the last 20 years?
Yes.
When I studied in the Inner Sanctum at the Academy, there was a man named Deluin who was my teacher. And he spoke quite highly of his sister, Desiel. And his favorite pupil was Adrian. And we will conclude there.
I fucking hate him.
I'm sweating so much.
I hate him.
This wasn't what I thought I was going to do today. What did I even say that started this? What did I even do?
You said you're from the Avith Woods.
That's where I've told everyone that. That's not a secret.
I'm a boss.
That's where it always goes wrong for you.
Uh-huh. Well.
Oh God, I definitely told Arthur too much.
Yeah. Oh, sure no. Did. Oh, shit.
Good Lord. Well, friends, thanks very much for watching this evening.
Thank you, Sarah.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you ever so much.
If you're new here, make sure you follow so you can find us again. We stream D&D 2 to 4 times a week currently, depending on our schedule. Tales of Settendor, my campaign, we just have the epilogue to go. We're also going to be doing a series of one-shots in the world as well in the future, so stay tuned for those. But this week we have Princes of the Apocalypse tomorrow at 6 p.m. Eastern Time. That's an hour different for those of you outside of the United States than it is normally. And then on Friday we'll be doing a fireside chat and some board game stuff. So if you're around, come on down, ask us some stuff, and we'll have a wonderful time.
Yeah, I'll have more stuff to talk about my homebrew campaign. If y'all have more questions, I've started prepping more so I can answer
Candyland? No, not Candyland. We're going to save that for when Kelsey is available.
Yeah. Fucking Candyland.
Yeah,
Candyland.
You trying
to Candyland?
Yeah. We could just play Candyland more than once. Possible. I kind of want to play
Friday. Candyland.
Maybe.
Right. I can give you a Lawrence, strong you name.
We might play Candyland.
Friday night.
Sorry, chat.
Can't.
Damn.
Wedding.
Okay. Thank you for the follow.
Thank you for the follow.
Hey, thank
Peachy
you.
X Keen and Moan Will or Monet Will or Money Will. Also never to be ignored. Star Launa, thank you very much. I appreciate it. I hope you enjoyed this evening's episode. We'll be back tomorrow and Friday, 6 p.m. Eastern Time. That's it. If you're new, go to our website, notgreatrpg.com. You'll find everything else you need to know about us, all of our previous recaps and episodes and all that fun stuff. Go check it out. I love you guys.
Bye.
See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Thank you.
Who's the criminal now, green boy?
Right.
17. Is it a common belief system to leave nature to do as it wants?